All right, joining us on Hot Copy, the international award-winning director who bagged the Best Director Award in the Metro Manila Film Festival for his movie, Thy Womb. Director Brillante Mendoza is with us this morning. Good morning. Congratulations for coming. Now, I'm sure it wasn't a surprise anymore. You won Best Director, was it?
Well, siyempre, iba pa rin kapag nasa Pilipinas tayo, kapag nasa ano ka dito. So, nakakaba pa rin.
Talaga? Kumbaga sa dami ng awards na napanalunan mo sa ibang bahagi ng mundo?
Iba kasi pag nasa Pilipinas ka eh, iba pa rin yung kaba. Kinakabahan niya ako habang naglalakad ako eh. So,
talaga?
Yeah.
Oo, all right. Now, you have Nora Honor, your lead actress, winning the Best Actress, but Thy Womb didn't win Best Picture. Mm-hmm. How do you feel?
Well, siyempre, we had I think 5 major awards.
Tell us. Okay,
we got the best actress, we have the best director, the best production design, the best cinematography, original story. These are major awards already, in a major festival. So, we were thinking that we're going to get the best picture.
Yeah.
Because it follows when you have this major in any, you know, in any festival, in any award-giving bodies, it follows. So they get the best picture. So we were quite surprised. But we were very happy with what we got.
Uh-oh.
So we were very happy. Well, and also we were surprised why, for instance, the box office is included as one of the criteria in judging the best film.
Pero are you sure about that, Direk? Because see, MMDA Chairman Tolentino was here on Head Start and he said, Karen, tinanggal na ang box office criteria as a box office sales as a criteria for best picture. The film will only be judged for its quality. Is that true?
Well, I was told last night that 30% of the criteria of the best film is the box office sales. Box office sales. And we didn't fall in that category. You know, wala kami doon. Zero kami doon.
Pero who told you that? Was it a legitimate organizer?
Part of the committee.
Part of the committee?
Yes.
So that is disappointing because according to Chairman Tolentino, yes, tinanggal ang box office sales.
Yes. They had to clear that among themselves because a part of the committee told me that we should have won the best film because we got the major awards. And unfortunately, he told us you didn't fall in this category. It's 30%. Even if you got like perfect score on the 70%, but you know, 30% is still big.
Yeah. Were you perfect in the 70%?
I didn't know.
All right, so you are disappointed that box office sales is included?
Yes, okay. Yes. Because in a festival like this, we are happy that we're part of this festival and that we're hoping that we'll be part of it until the very end, no?
Yeah.
So, kung box office ang pinag-uusapan, of course, gumagapang kami dyan di ba? And our market is, we're not a priority, we're not an alternative film, no?
That's true. So, you are an alternative film.
Yes, and for the viewers, we are an alternative choice. Mm-hmm. We are not the
Tama
first
ka.
Choice.
Oo, mukhang so, Sister Rakas ang first choice.
Yes, or an horror film or a comedy. So, we fall under the cat, siguro nandun kami sa fourth, fifth, and our audience would come towards the end of the festival. So you cannot judge it, you know, you cannot judge the film. And plus, there's no equal number of cinemas. We have only like 44 on the first day, while others have 130 cinemas. So kami, nabawasan pa kami. Okay, naging 27 na lang. While the rest, nadagdagan pa. So how can you have that as part of the criteria, no, sa box office? So parang hindi yata hindi yata balance.
Now let's start with this. The raffling of the films.
Yes.
Because Chairman Tolentino, in fairness to him, said prior to him becoming MMDA chair, this was already eto na yung kalakaran. There are 320 plus theaters in Metro Manila. Yun lang ang raffled.
Yes.
Pero sa probinsya, Davao, they have a lot of theaters.
Yes.
It's the theater owners who choose the movie.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Do you agree with that system?
Well, sana when you have a, you know, in a festival like this, sana fair lahat. I mean, we are happy that you have only 8 Filipino films showing during this duration of ano, parang festival. So sana sa lahat yun, because we cannot really compete. Of course, they would pick the film with the most stars. Alam mo naman natin sa probinsya, di ba? Eh kung sinishare natin ito sa mga Filipino audience, hindi lang naman ang Filipino audience nasa Metro Manila. Ang Filipino audience are all over the Philippines, and this is a Filipino film festival. It's not just the Metro Manila. So it's a Filipino. That's what I would like to think, no? It's a Filipino film festival. Eh kung magko-concentrate ka lang sa Metro Manila film, Metro Manila, eh tama nga siguro yung pangalan niya. Wag mo nang sabihin ito. This is for the Filipino audience. And this is for the Filipino cinema goers.
So, all right. Now, when it comes to the system. It turns out that a movie, any movie, has to hit a 1 million mark on the first day. Mm-hmm. If not, the theater owner, even in the raffled areas, have the right to pull out the movie. Mm-hmm. I heard that Thy Womb, I think, I'm not sure if it was a Robinson's Theater, one of those theaters, by 2 p.m., they changed it to, I think, Enteng Agimat.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that?
Definitely, I don't agree with that. I don't agree with that. What if my audience, like what I've said, this is a different kind of film. We're alternative. We cannot really compete with the mainstream. So my audience, in fact, our gross really, nag-ano siya talaga, I mean, the last, yung last screening. Dahil nandun mature audience, we are PG-13 eh.
Of course, PG-13.
Yeah, and the rest of the films are GP. I think you have like 3 or 4 films na GP. Kami PG-13. Of course, our audience, nasa ano yan, bandang gabi yan. So, if you pull out at 2 o'clock, eh, wala nang chance, no? There are a lot of people who are sending us messages, bakit wala dito, bakit na pull out dito. So, and we cannot do anything.
What did you do? I mean, my God! As the director and I think the producer of the film, how did you feel?
Well, of course, I feel bad, but we're helpless. Wala kaming magagawa eh. These are cinema owners. You can only do so much, no? Wala. We can only rely to people like you from the media who will help us at least air our side, no? But other than that, wala talaga kaming magagawa.
But if you were ABS-CBN, GMA7, I mean Viva Films, let's be honest.
Yeah.
These cinema owners will not do that to your movie na ganun-ganun lang.
Of course. Kasi kami nga, as alternative cinema, hindi naman kami nagpapalabas ng pelikula every month or at least twice a month, diba? So, itong mga major companies na to, they have films, you know.
Yes.
I mean, 12 days. Yes, they have clout. We don't have that. We don't have this kind of clout. So, we can only rely to, you know, yun na nga, pang second, third choice lang kami. So, ganun lang talaga, ganun ang kalakaran, ganun ang sistema. But if there will be people like, for instance, in this festival na talagang totoo, talagang they have the political will to change the system, magagawa yan eh. Magagawa yan, kayang gawin yan eh.
Now, is it encouraging the present system? Is it encouraging to actually... is it encouraging for independent, really talented directors? You know what I mean? That don't take the commercial route to join? Because what do you see? Like Sundance Film Festival, you really see independent young directors, films that they would not do in Hollywood, lumalabas sa Sundance.
You know, when we got accepted, finally, because we were also rejected initially in this festival, parang cue yun sa amin eh, di ba? It opened doors. Somehow, that's how we felt, no? It opened doors somehow to independent cinema to make our films accessible to the Filipino audience. Kasi yun nga, yung venue, ganyan-ganyan. So, we are thankful with that, no? Sa initial. Kaya lang, it's not really encouraging. A lot of young filmmakers, especially mga independent, they look up to me somehow in a way because, you know,
They do.
So, ito, pag nakita nilang ganito ang nangyayari sa akin, eh ako na ito. Paano pa sila? Paano pa sila kung silang makakasama dito? So, ayun na. But as a whole, kaming mga independent filmmakers and mga alternative films and independent producers, somehow, generally happy naman kami. Happy naman kami kahit papaano nabigyan kami ng chance. No? Pero yun na nga. And kailangan lang ganun talaga yung kalakaran, wala kang
magagawa. What do you want changed? No, how do they do it in Tribeca? That's in New York. That's a film festival.
You know, in a legitimate film festival, if you get accepted, you know, dapat yung duration ng festival nandoon ka regardless of
sales.
Have, of sales.
Yeah.
If you have like 300 people watching or 3,000 people and you have 3 people watching this film.
Uh-oh.
You know, and you don't, and box office is not really a criteria.
Oh, tama rin yun, ha? You're right. In any, you know, so in Sundance, in Tribeca, hindi talaga.
Yeah.
And even in Cannes.
Most especially in Cannes,
wala.
You know, in other festival, we only have like, I remember watching a film, and there were only like 5 of us watching it. And it got the best film. It got the best story, it got the best screenplay. Wala yan sa ano. Then you should have people judging the film, at least people from the industry, legitimate people from the industry judging films. You shouldn't get, you know, ordinary people watching. Because otherwise, laglag ka na dun. Because syempre, they would see the film as, you know, kung sino ang artista dito, kung ano yung production value, and ano yung laki ng pelikula. Dami ng artista. That's how ordinary audience would judge it.
So I think MMDA chair told me there were 12 to 13 judges. Was there in this MMFF wherein he added 5 ordinary people? A bus driver, an OFW, a housewife, a Muslim, and I think a student. Is that a good idea?
This is a commercial film festival, so siguro okay lang yun. Because mainstream eh. So they would judge it that way, no? Ganun ang... But if you want to legitimize the festival, gusto mo talaga siyang itaas ang quality ng mga films. You shouldn't have... You know, parang ordinary
movie not goers. Experts like me, for example. I'm an ordinary moviegoer.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be in any other festivals abroad as a judge. Who would they have?
They should have producers.
Uh-oh.
They should have actors. They should have critics, journalists.
Really? Pwede journalist? Okay, pwede ako.
Yeah, pwede ka. Pwede ka. Actually, marami na rin ng mga... Because, naiintindihan mo naman.
Talaga. Okay.
And they should have people from the academe.
Meron na nun, no?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Now, another interesting point with this whole thing is the Metro Manila Film Festival was formed to promote culture, heritage, I think the best in Filipino cinema.
Yeah.
There's a definition when it was actually, you know what I mean? When it was built, and then it's a time to showcase Filipino movies the best of, so that there's no competition with Hollywood movies.
Yes.
Do you still believe we follow that?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so. When you have films that are, you know, fantasies, horror, genre movies.
Okay.
Yeah, these are parang ano ito, basis ito ng Hollywood eh. Yun ang kasi sinusundan natin eh. The thing with us, you know, we look up Hollywood so much, no? Parang yun na talaga yung basis at criteria natin.
Anything, and they will do well close, in a commercial run.
Of course.
Yeah, already. Course. I mean, like, Enteng and Sister Akas. I think Sister Akas, even if may katabi yun na, frankly, Hollywood film, kikita yun.
Of course. You have the mainstream actors there, di ba? Well, at the end of the day, it's Christmas, no? And people wants to be, we are in a festive mood, and they want to see this kind of films, no? And I fully understand that. Pero unfortunately, conflicting yung ano objective, no?
Yeah.
Conflicting. You want to entertain, but at the same time you want to upgrade the quality of Filipino films. You cannot have, you know, two things done at the same time. Hindi mo
you
kaya.
Really can't.
You really can't, you know. And how can you how can you do like you? A lot of these films are still on a post production stage 2-3 days before the festival. Where in the world you have this kind of ano festival? So, paano mo ma-upgrade ang quality nun? Kung nagsushooting ka pa 3 days before the ano, or nagsushooting ka pa ng nagpo-post ka pa ng 3 days before the festival.
Oo, talaga.
Wala namang ganun, di ba? So And then a lot of them complained while we are, you know, while we have our film, for instance, sa mga film festival abroad. Of course, we finish ahead of everyone.
That's true.
Like several months before everyone.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. Do you think we'll ever make it to the Oscars for Best Foreign Film? I mean, I'm curious. What will it take?
Dapat meron talagang sincerity, no? Sincerity, okay. And meron talagang wala yung crab mentality.
Uh-oh.
And meron
because
talaga,
lobby rin yun, you have to push.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
Oscars.
Yeah. And you should have the major support of people who understand
Uh-oh.
The film, no?
Uh-oh.
Not people from, you know, unfortunately kasi dito may body na namimili, no? And yun. You cannot just submit your film. There is an organization who choose the film, and you have this organization from the industry na who chooses film, no? But at the same time, when you choose a film, you also have to find out, study, no?
Yeah.
Ano yung criteria, what makes it to the Oscars, and then once you make it to, you know, one of the list doon, finalists doon, dapat you should have the major support from the government.
Uh-oh.
Or from
Uh-oh.
The Filipino film industry. Kasi it's not just about being chosen, it's also about pushing and knowing the right people.
No? Abroad.
Abroad.
Abroad, yeah.
Abroad. Hindi pwedeng, natanggap tayo, one of the 60.
Yun na.
Yun na.
Okay, we'll be right back. We'll continue our conversation with MMFF's best director, Brillante Mendoza. Stay tuned, Hot Copy. We'll be right back. Back to Hot Copy, stars added glitz and glam to the awards night as they made their stunning entrance on the red carpet. Here's a look at the winning looks of the evening. I want to see this.
On the sidelines of the 38th Mer Manila Film Festival were the fans who were eager to catch a glimpse of their idols as they walked on the red carpet at the Meralco Theater. Most male celebrities, including Zanjo Marudo, Cesar Montano, and Ding Dong Dantes, came in black suits. Governor E.R. Ejercito wore white, a perfect match to the outfit of superstar Nora Honor. Amid controversy stirred by the movie El Presidente, Ejercito urged organizers not to pull out his movie from cinemas.
Oh, dahil ang dalawa sa top grosser ngayon, 130 films, 130 theaters each. Kaya kami 54 lang. Kawawa naman yung Daewoom, El Presidente, yung Strangers. Kawawa naman yung maliliit na producer. Sana madagdagan naman sinihan next year. Sana ang raffle next year para sa buong Pilipinas. Sana ang MMFF maging the Filipino Film Festival.
Angel Oxin was beautiful in her Roberto Cavalli dress. She arrived with her boyfriend, Phil Young husband. The media asked about their plans to settle down.
Wala pa, wala.
Oh, yeah.
blinds pa lang, pero walang meron.
Christine Reyes wore a see-through bejeweled gown. Casey Concepcion came in the lacy black number styled by Bang Pineda. The queen of all media, Chris Aquino, drew attention in her daring cleavage-bearing gown by Kari Santiago. Nora Honor and former President Joseph Estrada were named male and female star of the night.
With us in the studio, Metro Manila Film Fest Best Director for Thy Womb, Brillante Mendoza, is with us now. Seeing the trailer, of course, I have to say, you are a brilliant director. Your name is Brillante. But that particular theme, it's, I mean, they're bajaos. She's a midwife in the movie, Nora Honor. Yes. We discussed this during dinner. Is the subject even something people will want to watch?
No, actually, is not actually. Kumbaga, hindi siya audience talagang easily, no, accepted by the audience.
Yeah.
But, you know, you have to do films like this. You have to somehow do this kind of cinema. Kasi otherwise, if you don't have these alternative choices, of our odds, so mga audience natin, they ended up, you know, appreciating and watching just one kind of cinema, which is, you know, yung entertainment.
That's
the
true.
Entertainment
I
side,
agree.
Which is Hollywood,
yes.
No? Which is what the mainstream is doing.
Yeah.
So that's why we offer films like this, so that our audience can also think somehow.
Yeah,
they
yeah.
can also get
and,
informed.
And learn culture, frankly. A deeper understanding.
Yes, yes. Uh-oh. Not only about our culture, but basically about our, you know, about us, you know, Filipinos.
Uh-oh.
Ang dami nating hindi alam, no? Because we are only concentrated here, dito sa Luzon. Hindi natin alam mga kwento sa Mindanao,
mm-mm.
sa Visayas. Ang dami-dami. We're so rich sa kultura.
Okay.
And we don't know this, no? And of course, when you offer this kind of cinema, easily ang mga audience parang, baka ano yan, boring yan, you know, they would think that way. But you have, if you have all these kind of films, wala silang choice, panonoorin nila yan,
yeah.
di ba? Panonoorin nila yan.
Uh-oh. Now, okay, I want to include this in the discussion because Head Start always looks at how social media reacts. And one of the PR guys or writers, Eric Jan Salut, who has 216,000 followers, wrote this on his Twitter account. I'll read it as is. Ginamit nyo na naman ang awards para buhayin ang karir niyan. Leche. That's his tweet. Moving up, you will notice that you have a group of people, including him, that were questioning Nora Honor's win and believed that Angel Locsin should have won the Best Actress Award. And it gets very critical of, Nora Honor. Your thoughts on that?
Well, I think ako naman nirerespeto ko yung mga
opinion.
Opinion, okay? This is a free country. So, respected to yan. But if you're asking me, siguro naman hindi magkakamali ang APSA.
Yeah.
Okay, hindi magkakamali ang Venice.
Yeah.
Venice is the oldest festival in the world. Hindi ka
really?
Pa buhay.
Oh, oh.
Festival na yan. So, at ang APSA is one of the most prestigious because it's Asia-Pacific.
Wow.
Ibig sabihin from Russia to China to Japan, Korea, they're all included, you know, in this
yeah.
film, in choosing
yeah.
the best actress in this, in, you know, and the best
Uh-oh.
Film, you know, from among this region.
Uh-oh.
Siguro naman, and these are legitimate people from the industry, siguro naman di sila magkakamali.
Yeah. Now, why do you think, do you have... showbiz writers or PR people in the Philippines who treat Nora this way? I mean, in the US, if Meryl, kasi ako, I would equate Nora to Meryl Streep,
yes.
ha, frankly.
Yes.
In the US, Meryl Streep is the expected winner. If you beat Meryl Streep, yun yung himala.
Yes.
Baliktad, parang
yes.
diba?
Yes, of course.
She's been nominated 19 times in the Oscars.
Yeah.
Sometimes she wins, sometimes she loses.
Mm. You know, yun na nga, dito kasi sa atin, nandun pa rin tayo sa star, no? Star mentality.
Oo, dali din na siya star, that, parang ganun.
But, you know, Nora Honor is Nora Honor, no matter what. Whether you're a Vilmanian, kung ano ka pa man dyan, Nora Honor will be Nora Honor. You know, this is already part of our Philippine film ano history.
Yeah.
Hindi mo yan natin pwedeng tanggalin. And let's, ano, let's be fair, okay? Magaling siyang artista. Magaling siyang artista. And ako mismo, naintindihan ko yon at nalaman ko. You know, this is my first time working with her. Kung pinakinggan ko lahat ng mga tao nagsasabi sa akin before I work with her, hindi na natuloy yan.
Oh.
Yes. Because a lot of negative things that were, you know, people
yeah.
are saying against
yeah.
Nora Honor. But it's a personal experience. Nakita ko that she's really a passionate actress. An artist siya. Artist
Uh-oh.
Siya. So, doon ko naintindihan kung bakit siya nagtagal ng ganito.
Mm-mm.
Okay,
Mm-mm.
so I think she deserves respect. Okay, from the industry and from us, no? Mga Filipino, she deserves that. Kahit ano pang nangyari sa buhay niya, she's an artist and she's a great actress.
Okay. All right, JK Morales asks, how does it feel that you won pero hindi kayo pumatok sa takilya?
Well, at the end of the day, syempre, nakakasama ng loob yan, di ba? But you cannot have everything.
You
no?
can't.
You can't have everything.
But I'll be honest with you, Direk Brillante, when you won in the Cannes Film Festival, that subject would not have made it commercially also,
yeah,
huh?
Of course. Yeah, of course. Ako naman, realistically, hindi naman ako, like what I've said, hindi ako maasang maging number one, naging number two. I'm just trying to create an audience.
A new one.
A new audience for this kind of cinema. Because I know I don't have the Filipino audience, you know. Alam ko yon.
Okay.
It's just that now, with this kind of cinema, we are trying to create a new, parang audience for alternative.
True.
So, yun. So, dapat, kahit papaano, merong political will from different groups, no? From
yeah.
the media, from the government, to create this kind of audience.
Yeah.
Para magkaroon tayo ng film,
yeah.
talagang
yeah.
film appreciation.
Now, because
no?
to be honest, you go to Europe, they don't really like Hollywood films all that much. Theaters in Paris are showing French movies
yes.
and small movies,
yeah.
but rarely is it really... Mm-hmm. There will be, of course, the Hollywood movies,
yeah.
pero, I mean, they know different types of movies.
Yes, yes. Like, you know, alimbawa, sa France, no, you have like 60 million population. Of the 60 million, hindi naman lahat yan manunod ng pelikula eh. But you have like at least 4 million or 5 million regular moviegoers of alternative cinema. And these are regular audience, no matter what.
Yeah.
Yun yung kine-create natin dito. We have like 100 million Filipinos.
Yes.
And there were only like 40% of us watching films. But out of this 40%, wala ngang 1 million, not less
Uh-oh.
Than a million nga ang nanonood. Wala pang 100,000 nanonood ng mga alternative films.
Oh, wala.
This is what we are trying to create.
Uh-oh. But would you ever make a commercial film? I mean, I'm honest with this. Would you ever make like this is One More Try, no? The best picture.
Yeah, yeah.
Or even in the past, no other woman of Ann Curtis that went insane in the box office. You know, those kinds. Would you consider directing that kind of movie?
Never.
Never?
Never.
Oh my God, because to be fair to you, Direk, you already work. They may think, Direct Brillante has already worked with Gina Lopez of ABS-CBN. Yes, yes. So, in other words, Direct Brillante has had the ABS-CBN exposure somehow with the ABS-CBN projects. But you would never make that kind of movie?
No.
Bakit? I'm really curious. Why
not? Kasi each filmmaker, we have our own ways of telling stories. Okay. I'm not against commercialism.
Okay.
I'm not against mainstream. But their objective is just to entertain. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. That's the objective of the filmmaker, and that's the objective of the major companies. No, that's not my objective. I have an advocacy while I make film.
Talaga?
Yes. It's not just to entertain. It's to inform. It's to educate. It's to share cinema.
Uh-oh.
It's to understand cinema. It's not just about entertainment. Film is not just about entertainment. To us Filipinos,
my God, bilib ako sa iyo.
Filipinos, to us, film is nothing but entertainment.
Yeah.
That's why we're a copycat of Hollywood films. Eh. Because what is Hollywood? Hollywood is just to entertain people, no? Para makalimutan ang lungkot, para makalimutan ang mga problema. That's for us, cinema.
Oh, but ito, would you make a movie like Relacion? I remember that old Vilma Santos movie.
Yeah.
That one you would.
Yeah, I would make a film like that, but it's not an all-out commercial film.
Oh, the reason why Ishmael Bernal. Yes, because I remember that when I was young.
Yeah, in fact, I even told, I think I told one of the, in my interviews, that's one of the, you know, best film I've seen when I was
young. Oh, relationship-based.
Yes, relationship-based. But it's not an all-out commercial film. I mean, it became commercial because you have Vilma Santos, you have
Christopher De Leon.
So, and it was produced by a commercial or by a mainstream production.
Yes.
So, let's put it this way. Ang ano kasi ano ba yung mainstream, ano ba yung commercial, ano ba yung independent? Kahit naman nasa commercial festival ka, independent pa rin naman kami, alternative kami. Because I remember one journalist asked told me, welcome to the commercial world. Sabi ko, bakit commercial? Sabi ko, commercial ka na ngayon. Sabi ko, I'm not. I'm still alternative. I'm still independent. My company is independent. I'm independent. I'm producing independent films like this. My films are alternative. They're not mainstream. So
yeah.
I cannot be commercial, even if I am in this commercial. But I'm very thankful that we are in this festival because somehow, naging accessible yung film namin.
Yeah. That's true. Okay. Echo N. Hin Yero asks, deserving bang manalo as third best picture? Hindi ko tanong to, ha? Ang Sister Rakas, kahit walang napanalunang major awards compared to Thy Womb. But because you said 30%, can you explain that? Sister Rakas is third best picture.
Yeah, I think on that aspect, no. Kaya medyo magulo ang mga criteria, no. So dapat tanggalin talaga yung ano, yung
box office sales.
Otherwise, they will run with all the major awards kapag nandoon 'yan.
So, all right. Melvin Leonard Sabio asks, do you think the Filipino masses have a low taste for the arts, especially in movies?
Hindi yun kasalanan ng mga Filipino audience natin. Like what I've said, you know, Hollywood films, American films were introduced to us 50 years ago.
I agree.
So, yun ang ano natin. Yun
ang exposure,
exposure natin. And then you have mainstream cinema series, puro mga star. So, yun ang ating take of what is a good film. So, sa ibang bansa, yung film culture, yung film appreciation, bata ka pa, pinapalabas na yan, di ba? Pinapakita na. Yun ang sinasabi ko nga eh. Dapat you have to, kumbaga, i-cultivate mo yan. You cannot just ask a person, ito, winner ito, maganda to. At dapat maganda rin ang tingin mo dyan sa pelikula. You cannot do that overnight.
Uh-uh.
It has to have, you have to have a political will, and it has to come from the government.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay? So educational system, information, no?
Mm.
So hindi mo yun magagawa overnight.
Yeah. No, but I know what you're trying to say because us on television, in news and current affairs, have that same dilemma.
Mm-hmm.
Do you give the audience what they need or have to know?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you give them just what they want to see? So it's the same thing.
Yeah,
you put crime, you put CCTV, you put how a murder was done, the audience loves it. Mm. Then you put documentaries that are, let's say, on education, nutrition, and then the ratings aren't that high and you think you don't need them, which I also don't agree with. Because it's the point is, you have a platform.
It's the same thing with us. So, yun na nga eh. Kapag advocacy mo kasi yan, you don't care about ratings. Okay? Kapag
but is advocacy, that even, is that possible in the real world?
There's a way. Ako kasi, fighter kasi ako eh.
Uh-oh.
So, kapag gano'n yan, even if everybody's against it, okay, I will still do it. If nobody will gonna help me, you know, in doing this kind of cinema, I'll still do it. I'll still gonna do it. No matter what.
Eh, yung kasabihan na, what's the point? Sa TV may kasabihan kami. Na anong point ng ginagawa mo gusto mo?
Kung wala nanonood, kung wala nanonood
sa'yo.
Hindi. Because hindi manunood ang mga tao ngayon. We just don't think this at this time, no? Hindi lang tayo ngayon mag-iisip. Ang isipin natin yung future.
Mm-mm.
Like for instance, if you have like 1,000 audience, okay? And this 1,000 audience laugh of your film. And they all like it and they clap it and they'll go out of the cinema. Do you think they will remember the film? They will just remember the fun and the joy in those 2 hours.
Uh-huh.
But at least, you know, sasabihin sa inang filmmaker ng major, we did our objective. You know, objective. Yes. Ako hindi eh. Out of the 1,000, I'm already okay with one person.
Whose life will be changed.
Whose life will be changed. Because that person, you know, will live to tell this to these children, to the future generation, how his life was changed by this one film.
I want you to tell me, before we go to a break, name me one film, not a Filipino film, or any film, actually, that really affected you as a director and changed your life. I'm thinking of mine right now. What's yours? Yeah.
Well,
do you remember one?
I remember one. Actually, I was so inspired. I was so inspired when I saw this film in Cannes. It's called 4 months, 4 months, 3 weeks, 2 days.
4 months, 3 weeks, 2 days. Okay, what was it?
It's about the woman who had an abortion.
Oh, you see, okay. So these are, they did the struggle, the internal, what a woman goes through. I see. All right, let's take another break. Hot Copy, we'll be right back. We'll read your questions from Twitter. Welcome back to Hot Copy. With us is MMFF's best director, Brillante Mendoza. I just like to announce, a Laguna Governor E.R. Ejercito actually confirmed that he was coming to the show last night. And he was already in the show, I believe, I think a few months ago. But he won't be able to make it this morning because it's due to an emergency. So I hope Governor Ejercito that all is well. Okay. I want you to comment on this. Kiko Acero says, I disagree that Hollywood is to blame. Our films have a greater sense of Bollywood in them. No, but Bollywood is very Indian culture, huh?
Yeah.
To be fair, to Bollywood. Yeah. Comment on that.
Well, at least they have an identity.
Yes, they do, no?
They have an identity and they patronize their own film.
They do, no? In India. How in do they India. Do it? They have the biggest, you know, India is the bigger film producer than...
In the world.
In the world, than in Hollywood. World,
yes, than Hollywood, yes.
Okay, tell me, how do they do it?
Well, the people, they go to, the Indian people, they go to watch this kind of cinema. At least they patronize their own.
Yeah.
Better than Hollywood, okay? Tayo naman kasi, wala tayong ganung sense, no, of identity. We don't have an identity. Ang identity natin abroad, ang identity natin is melodrama. That's our identity.
That's true.
Melodrama.
Yeah, I know the melodrama.
Telenovela.
There's always screaming.
Yes. I mean, the louder you shout, the better.
Oh.
So, yun yung ano natin. And I'm not kidding. I'm not joking. That's how they see us. So, ang hirap mong i-break yung ganung klaseng, when I show my films abroad, ang hirap kasing i-break yung ganung klaseng mentality. Because
the louder you shout,
yes,
the better. Yes. Okay. Go on.
Yun ang identity natin sa abroad, unfortunately.
No, I was gonna say, without naming a movie, locally, that's not to offend anyone, but when in the Philippines, you have wives screaming at their husbands or people screaming at each other, but there is not much of that scene wherein you have someone like Emma Thompson, mm-hmm. wherein she knows she's being cheated on, and there's just no lines. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And it's just, I mean, if she's mad, it's just saying it without much. We don't have that. Or maybe is it not cultural in us?
It's not cultural in us. Kasi Filipinos, here in the Philippines, you know, you have to consider the audience always. Eh. You always think of how will the audience react before even doing the right thing. Iniisip po na kagad eh. So, for instance, sa atin, if a housewife is like working while watching television, she has to hear that, even if she's not looking at the monitor or on the television.
Yeah. Now, Star Cinema, ABS-CBN, has offered you to direct movies before many times, but you've always turned them down. Well, turned us down because I work in ABS. But why is that?
Well, I don't like to work on a formula movie.
Okay. You know,
they have to follow a certain formula kasi.
Would you do something like Crying Ladies? That Sharon Cuneta, what was that?
Unitel.
Yeah. Would you do something like that? It's slightly offbeat,
but why not?
It was funny and you cry. Would you would?
Yeah, I mean, a film, something like of course, it's gonna be the same treatment, but something like that.
It's different. Oh, parang hindi yung formula.
It's not formula, yeah.
Ano ba yung formula para sa'yo?
Formula, of course, one of the basic ng formula is that, restorative ang ending. Nasa-solve ang problema. Which is not true. In real life. It's not true. Life goes on. After one problem, there will be another problem. Maybe less problem, maybe a bigger problem. But that's not life.
But I've been noticing that a lot of Filipino movies are doing a lot of themes on cheating. I mean, I've noticed that, huh? Because movies wherein they're cheating on their husbands or wives or partners are making so much money in the box office.
Yeah. Well, kasi tayo, I think it nanggagaling yun sa pagiging moralistic natin because we're a Catholic country. So, when we see something like this, parang ano yung pagkatao mo, mayroon ding nandadaya. Katulad ko, pwede rin palang mandaya.
Okay, so, but isn't that how it should be? Shouldn't movies reflect who we are? Can we relate to?
Of course. I completely agree with you. But not the way these films are being shown.
Okay.
In real life, you don't have this kind of women or this kind of houses or this kind of lines or this kind of situation where everything happens in one day. You know, a wife being killed and then somebody commits suicide and all this happening in one day. You don't have that in real life.
All right. Okay. Last words, Direk Brillante. I just want to read this. This is nice on Twitter. Albert, the boss, says, I commend Brillante Mendoza for showcasing films that have sense in today's society. Independent films forever. So that's great feedback for you. Yeah. All right. Okay. Somebody asking, Brillante Mendoza on Head Start, is this live? Yes, it's very, very, very live. All right. Last word, sir.
Yeah, so I just like to appeal to the cinema owners to please
don't pull out the movie.
Don't pull out the movie yet.
Yeah.
So we still have, I think, 23 or 27 cinemas, so I hope we'll stay until the very end of the festival. So, and to all the people who haven't seen the film, please find for yourself why it won awards here and abroad.
Yes.
And please support the film.
Yes. Now, to the big cinemas out there, that's the SM Cinemas, frankly, and the Ayala Cinemas. Are they the biggest, the two largest?
Yeah. Okay. Robinson's.
Yeah. So, to the SM Cinemas, Ayala Cinemas, and Robinson's Cinemas, I think Direk Brillante Mendoza has a point. Don't pull out the movies. It's the Metro Manila Film Festival. I mean, I think it's worth it to just let it stay until the end of the showing. And what's your next project?
My take on the paranormal activity in the Philippines. Paranormal activity.
Serious? You're doing paranormal? Oh, that's not commercial?
But my take on how I see it in a Philippine society.
So merong mga pamahiin yan. Okay. All right. Thank you so much, Direk. It's always been a pleasure. That's Yet Start today. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good weekend, everyone. And please take the time to watch all the Metro Manila Film Fest entries, especially Thy Womb. Take care, everyone.